Jesus said that what he preaches, he wants to capture everybody now.
God is good.
Okay.
Tell the person behind you that you are highly favored. Oh, you can come closer to her. So you are preaching now. Hallelujah. Okay, because it is very important. It's very important. Push the person behind you and say, God is about to do something.
God is about to do something.
That one, they will speak in French. Now, I believe that today is your first time of doing that. Don't you? Today is your first time, eh? Don't be nervous. If you keep on doing something like this, it is easy for you to preach. Amen?
Amen.
Place your hands on your chest. Father, we bless your word in the name of Jesus. The Bible says that your word do not come empty, but accomplish its purpose and reason. We seize this atmosphere. We bind any power, any demon, any principality that will exalt itself against the knowledge of God. We bind you, we cast you into the abyss. We destroy your activities in the name of Jesus. Amen. Holy Spirit, have your own way. Even as your word is coming, it will bring illumination. It will bring transformation. It will bring change in their destiny, in their life. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Somebody shout and say amen.
Amen.
Next week we'll be having a program from Friday, Saturday, Sunday. As a matter of fact, this program is one of the, you should not miss it, because I want God to do something for you. Can you go?
Hello. Bonsoir. Il y aura un programme la semaine prochaine, vendredi, samedi, dimanche.
Okay.
Il aimerait que tout le monde participe.
Okay, so it's going to be Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Vendredi, samedi, dimanche. Prochain.
Okay, the time is 6, we will come here, all of us will come here, 6:30 we will come, Saturday to 6:30, but Sunday is going to be the normal time, which is 3:30 to 6 o'clock.
Donc, vendredi, samedi, c'est à partir de 18h30, et puis le dimanche, c'est l'heure régulière.
Oui, and then all of us are going to do, we're going to fast, we are going to do, if you have never done a dry fasting before, this time we're going to do a dry fasting.
Alors, si vous n'avez jamais jeûné,
I know a lot of you say, oh, Pastor, me, I have my diabetes. Some people say that they are dead. They accept the sickness. The truth is that diabetes does not belong to you.
Donc la vérité, c'est qu'il y en a qui vont trouver l'argument qu'on est malade via du diabète.
And then some people also say, I have ulcer. So when they hear fasting, they say, me, I can't fast. Please, this time around, just try it and see.
Ceux qui ont l'ulcère, qui se trouvent dans l'ulcère, ne dites pas que j'ai l'ulcère.
I am betting you that out of this fasting, if every one of you is going to do it, the hand of God will fall here.
Yeah.
Si tout le monde faisait ce que le jeûne qu'il propose de faire, la main de Dieu va toucher tout le monde.
I think those who came here on Friday, I was saying that the day of Friday, we are eating nothing until in the evening. In the evening, the only thing you are going to do is, but if you are tired, if maybe you have never tried that before, if you are tired, go and get a grape juice or honey. The best one is honey. Okay, you can go and get honey, and then even as you are working, get honey, and then put it in a warm water and keep on drinking.
Donc, si tout au long de la journée, vous n'avez jamais jeûné de toute la journée, et si vous ne pensez pas à du jus de raisin ou du miel dans de l'eau tiède.
I hear people say,
la journée sans nourriture vraiment.
Okay, French is too long. How many? It's good, eh? Okay, it's good. We are going higher. Amen. Okay. Now the truth is that, you see, because I hear people say they don't dream. The best, medicine is for you to do this kind of fasting.
Alors, il y en a qui disent qu'ils n'ont jamais rêvé, mais qu'ils n'ont jamais rêvé ou jeûné. Donc, la meilleure des choses à faire. Il l'encourage à faire ce genre de jeûne.
Your spiritual man, meaning that, you know, when we talk about the Bible, say your spiritual man, meaning your soul, you begin to feel your soul.
Alors, vous allez sentir votre marque spirituelle, sentir votre âme.
The problem a lot of people have is that when they are fasting, they break the fasting. Sometimes when they drink something like orange, it's not good because there is an acid in the in it. So when you take it, I'm telling you, you're going to have a lot of problems in your day.
Donc après un jeûne vraiment sec, c'est préférable de prendre
The whole of Friday, you're not going to eat nothing, but you keep on drinking maybe the honey or grapes juice. You're going to drink it till the morning. And then till the morning, you're not going to eat nothing. Okay? What you do is you keep on drinking, what you call it, the honey. You keep on drinking the honey. Not only the honey, honey with what?
Water.
The second day, you will feel some fire around you. I'm telling you. You will feel like you are loaded. Something has come in you.
Donc on se sentira le lendemain matin avec comme un feu qui nous brûle vraiment. C'est-à-dire une puissance qui nous tient.
If you are doing hard work, try to drink, especially the grape juice. Voilà. Drink more.
Ceux qui ont du travail physique à faire, il encourage de prendre du jus de raisin.
We don't want you to fall in your workplace and they will call me and say, his pastor told her to do a fasting. And then,
il veut personne qui tombe sur son lieu de travail là, sans nourriture dans le ventre.
So you can drink more of that.
Voilà. Boire davantage de l'eau.
Okay, so on the Friday we come here in the evening, and then when you're coming, you're going to bring maybe something soft, like give me something soft.
Quelque chose de.
Please.
Donc, vendredi soir, en arrivant, essayez de prendre quelque chose de... Pour casser le jeûne. Quelque chose de léger.
Non, c'est porridge,
mais c'est pas un porridge. Ok, Caribbean porridge. You know, something light.
Quelque chose.
Yeah. Yeah.
Even if you're going to make soup, make sure that you make the soup without no, hard meat. So you can only use fish.
Pumpkin soup. No, any kind.
Pepper soup. How many of you eat pepper soup? You don't eat pepper soup, right?
No.
The woman is little at his time. You people should try it. It's good. You don't eat pepper soup. Okay.
Minestrone.
I think the Canadian also have a soup. Okay? You can do that one too. That one is fine, also lighter. We have a potato soup.
Potato.
But it's too heavy. Yeah, you can buy some in McDonald's, but make sure that you don't something light. And then we're going to break it after Friday, Saturday. We're going to enjoy that.
Okay.
And then on Sunday, we are going to bring something together. We're going to bring a little food. You are going to fast the whole of Sunday. Drink more water, drink more whatever, because there's going to be deliverance.
Amen.
If the enemy has deposited something in you, it's going to come out.
Amen.
Please. So you have to help me. I'm doing dry fasting for you. Amen. So you have to do yours. Amen.
Amen.
Don't be tempted by food. Don't be what? Push the person behind you and say, don't be tempted by food. Yesterday you went to do grocery. From tomorrow, eat all the food in the house. I give you the warrant. Eat all the food in the house. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, open the Bible with me to the 2 Kings chapter 7, verse 9. Second Kings chapter 7, verse 9.
Le livre des rois 2, chapitre 9.
Today I'm preaching on the whole month of August. We're going to be talking about something called good news. Say good news.
Good news.
Oh, shout and say good news.
Good news.
Now, when we talk about the good news, what is good news? Good news is talking about the kingdom of God. Nothing else but what? The kingdom of God. The kingdom of God. The kingdom of God. You see, the reason why God commissioned Jesus to come on this surface of earth is to come and amend the relationship between mankind and God. Romans chapter 3, verse 23, the Bible says, for all have sinned and fall short the glory of God. The only thing that God can do for humanity is to send his son so that he will die for everybody on this earth. And thank God for Jesus. Thank God for who?
Jesus.
And out of that is why Jesus came to die. The essence of the death of Jesus Christ was that because that time, he was the only person that was able to break that spirit called death. Say death.
Yeah.
So the only thing we remember about that is the death and the resurrection of Jesus. So anytime you hear about the good news, he's talking about the death and the resurrection of what? Jesus Christ. Push the person behind you and say, be ready. Or push him and say,
be ready.
About the kingdom. Okay, if you're there, you can read it for us, please. 2 Kings chapter 7, verse number 9.
Then said one to another, "Do not boil this day in the sea of Tyre. No, if we tarry till morning, some mischief will come upon us. Now therefore come, that we may go and tell the king's household."
Thank you very much. Open Mark chapter 1. Mark chapter 1, verse number 4. Mark chapter 1, verse number 4. You're doing well, so keep on. Don't be afraid. Continue. Mark chapter 1, verse number 14. Mark chapter 1, verse number 14.
Now, after that, John was.
Okay, come again.
Now, after that, John was put in prison. Jesus came into Galilee preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God.
Preaching the gospel. Say, preaching the gospel. Now, the mandate of Jesus Christ is to go out and preach the kingdom of God. He says, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me to preach the good news to what? The poor." Say the good news to the poor. Or say the good news to the poor. Now, if pastors and leaders and church members, we miss the mark by not talking about the gospel, ladies and gentlemen, we are missing a lot of things. If the body of Christ misses the mark, whereby we don't go out preaching the gospel to people, we are missing the mark. Now, a lot of pastors, a lot of leaders, a lot of church members are enticed about, the physical aspect of life. Where even when we are inviting a man of God, the person will ask, "How many congregations is the man of God having?" There was one day, somebody was inviting me. Because somebody went to tell the person that this man of God is dynamic. God is really using him. Now, the man of God called me and he said, "Man of God, I wanted to know a little about you." And then I said, "Okay, I'm just a son of God. So if I come there, God will just use me." He said, "Oh, I want to know much about you. How many members do you have? How many churches do you have?" I said, "You are crazy." You see, people are enticed about the physical aspect of the body and the kingdom of God. Instead of us to concentrate about the good news. The good news is nothing but speaking the word of God to other people. I'm with me, somebody.
Yes, sir.
Or sinners. I heard the man of God talking about evangelism. This month and the month of month ahead of us, our main priority is we are going to talk about nothing else but the good news. Say the good news.
Good news.
And one of your mandates is to go out. Just imagine next week, all of us get jinded. And then we say, "Open, everybody is going out and everybody is breaking the soul here." Next week here, it is going to be packed. How many of you are ready for that?
Amen.
Can you talk a little?
Yes.
Let's go.
Oh.
She stops. Amen. Okay. Okay.
No, but il parle d'annoncer la bonne parole aux gens.
Under the team, I've picked some few things I want to talk about. And I personally believe that if the world will embrace this thing, if the church will embrace this thing, the world will be a better place. Our families will be a better place. Our society will be a better place. The world will change from better to... Are you with me, somebody? Because the first thing I'll talk about is love. Say love.
Love.
Oh, shout and say love.
Love.
Now, you see, Americans are doing everything possible by entering into different countries and trying to use weapons so that they can, change people like out of democracy and trying to put democracy, put the democracy in different countries and all that. But the truth is that with all their weapons, this thing is not stopping. The battles in life will never stop until people get to understand that the biggest weapon we need is love. Summarize what I'm saying,
little. Absolutely. Donc, la chose la plus importante dont on a besoin, c'est l'amour. C'est vraiment l'amour.
The only thing that will bring change in our world, the only thing that cut across everything on this surface of earth, ladies and gentlemen, I have come on understanding that the only thing that will bring change is love, nothing else but love.
Le vrai changement, c'est l'amour.
I hear people talk about love, but they don't portray love. They don't do nothing about it. They just say it with their mouth.
Les gens parlent d'amour dans leur bouche, ils ne le disent pas avec le cœur.
Somebody will tell you I love you, but inside the person it is not love. Inside the person it is not love. And after doing a little research, I've come to understand that when we talk about the good news, ladies and gentlemen, you see, the Bible says God so loved the world. God himself is what? Love. God himself is what?
Love.
And without love, I'm telling you, you can't tell me you're a Christian without love.
On peut pas dire que qu'on est chrétien sans l'amour.
One of the attributes as a good Christian is when I begin to see that you are portraying love, you are showing love. If you don't have love, you don't have God.
Quand on n'a pas l'amour, on n'a pas Dieu.
I say, if you don't have love, you don't have God.
Quand on n'a pas l'amour, on n'a pas Dieu.
Open the Bible with me quickly. Open the Bible with me.
Ouvrez le bon.
1 John chapter 4. 1 John chapter number 4.
Premier livre de John 1, chapitre 4.
Verse number 14.
Premier livre de Jean.
1 John chapter 4.
John.
J-O-H-N.
Le livre 1 de Jean.
Le Jean. Le Jean is not John, right? Is it John?
It's John.
Ah, le Jean est
Jean.
Okay. Okay, let's go. Please, can we? I want to hear it more.
We have seen and you testified that the Father sent the Son to be the Savior of the world.
Continue.
Whosoever shall confess that Jesus is the Son of God, God dwelleth in him and he in God.
He said, whoever confess with his mouth. If you heard it well, it said, then God will dwell. So if you confess with your mouth that you're a Christian, now you become an incarnate of God. You behave as God. You react as God. You do your things as God. So you can't tell me you're a Christian and you begin to do things as unbeliever. Shout and say, I believe.
I believe.
So if God is in you, ladies and gentlemen, you have to behave as God. And God is love. God is what?
Love.
You see, there was one day, certain incidents happened in the world. I think that thing is when those people went to, they threw their bomb on America. You remember that? Yes, that event happened. Now, all the religious bodies came in, some people were condemning the people. So people were saying all sort of things. But you see, a certain man who was even a Buddhist came out and says, if all other religious bodies will understand that the only weapon we use and they will stop this thing is love, people took him for granted. But he said something very powerful. He says, if all the religious bodies will come together and understand that the biggest weapon we can use to silence this thing is love. Nothing else but love. Because once we are even going there with weapons, they are doing it more. And most of these things are prophecy. Nobody can put a stop to it. Are you with me, somebody?
Amen.
And I personally believe that for you to see, screen somebody and see whether the person has God, is for you to see loving around the person. Say love.
Love.
Shout and say love.
Love.
You don't need nothing. What you need is love. My question to you is that as a Christian, are you portraying love? In your workplace, do you have love? With your siblings, do you have love?
No.
I personally know that you may say, Pastor, a lot of people have done me a lot of harm, which is true. A lot of people you have helped who have turned against you, it is normal. But with all these things, you have to still show love. Say love.
No.
Because the Bible says Christ in you is the hope of glory. And then if you let Christ abide in you, ladies and gentlemen, you see, there are times you are doing things even your own fellow friends will not understand. But you have to do it with what? Love.
Donc il faut toujours montrer, démontrer de l'amour en fait autour de nous.
1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 4 to 5. Control the children for me. Those of you there, are you doing that for us? Or you want to join us here? Corinthians chapter 13, verse 4.
Charity suffereth long and is kind. Charity endeth not. Charity gotteth not itself, is not puffed up. Doth not behave itself unseemly, speaketh not her own, is not easily provoked, thinketh evil, rejoiceth not in iniquity, but rejoiceth in the truth.
Okay.
Beareth all things, believeth all things, hopeth all things, endureth all things. Charity never faileth, but whether there be...
The word charity there in other translation means love. Say love.
Love.
Okay. Our sister is going to, before you continue, she let her read the French one, please.
Okay, so chapter 13.
Yes. Verse 4. Verse
4. Donc l'amour est patient. Il est plein de bonté. L'amour n'est point envieux. L'amour ne se vante point. Il ne s'enflamme point d'orgueil.
Continue.
Il ne fait rien de malhonnête. Il ne cherche point son intérêt. Il ne s'irrite point. Il ne soupçonne point le mal. Il ne se réjouit point de l'injustice, mais il se réjouit de la vérité. Il excuse tout, il croit tout, il espère tout, il supporte tout.
Okay, read the English words, please.
Okay. It says, love never faileth, but whether there be prophecies, they shall fail. Whether there be tongues, they shall cease. Whether there be knowledge, it shall vanish away. For we know in part and we prophesy in part.
Continue.
But when that which is perfect is come, then that which is imperfect shall be done away. When I was a child, I spake as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. For now we see through a glass, darkly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then shall I know, even as also I am known. And now abideth faith, hope, love these things. Love these three, but the greatest of these is love.
The greatest of all these is what?
Love.
It's love. So if you can portray, if you can come and show me wonders upon wonders, if you can bring heaven on earth, if you can show me everything without love in you, you are nothing. You are nothing. So now when we begin to go deeper into this, you realize that in families, if there is, every love also comes with understanding. Love comes with what? Understanding. I'm telling you, the biggest weapon in love, the biggest key in love is understanding. Because if I understand you, I love you. And when there is no understanding, you people, the Bible says two people can never work together unless they agree. So if I want to work with you, I have to understand you. There are certain things before you come in, there are certain things as an individual, you know, you may not like it, but because you love the person, you just understand. You shouldn't be at a person that you all, every day of your life, you are there for opposition. Oh, I have to tell my mind. Then I have to say this. So in when we begin to have in marriages, your marriage will never work for you. Your relationship with your sisters and brothers will never work for you. Summarize a little.
Yes. Donc, la chose essentielle dans l'amour, c'est quoi? C'est l'amour. Quand il n'y a pas d'amour, il n'y a pas de compréhension, on ne peut aimer.
Mark chapter, before you continue, Mark chapter 12, verse 31. Quickly pick that for us. Mark chapter 12, verse 31.
Mark chapitre 12, verset 31.
Mark chapter 12, verse 31.
And the second is like, namely this, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself.
Now, continue.
There is none other commandment greater than this.
There is no other commandment. If you didn't hear nothing, he said there is no other commandment. So with all the 10 commandments that God gave to us, the biggest among all the other commandments is what?
Love thy neighbor as thyself.
Love thy neighbor. And who is your neighbor?
Everyone.
The person closer to you is your neighbor. So everybody is your neighbor. And the Bible says that the greatest of all the commandments is to portray love to each other. Now when we come here as an individual, ladies and gentlemen, do we show love? Do we show love? Summarize it later.
I have my neighbors. Donc, les commandements de Dieu, le deuxième commandement, le voici. Tu aimeras ton prochain comme toi-même.
Alors, il n'y a pas d'autre commandement plus grand que ces commandements-là. Donc, l'amour du prochain.
If we allow love to come in every situation, my dear, this place will be a better place. Because you put things there and nobody will steal it. Every day of your life, you move everywhere confidently. Even though you, it is true that some people are thinking evil of you, but if your heart is clean and you love everybody, oh my God, the Bible says no weapon that will fashion up against you will prosper. Are you with me, somebody? Because when they come with hatred, you are coming with love. And that is the biggest weapon. Say the biggest weapon. Now, you see, there are different kinds of love. There are about 8 kinds of love. But today I'll just talk about only 4 of them. And another time I'll go deeper into it. Now, there is one love called the Eros love. Say the Eros love.
Eros love.
Now, the Eros love is a love of affection. It's a love of what? Affection. So that is the kind of love. And a lot of women become victim of this kind of love. You meet this wonderful young man somewhere, and then he look at you and begin to calculate you. And begin to tell you, you are the apple in my tea. You are the sugar, whatever. And he'll begin to give you vibes and some things. And a lot of people, a lot of women especially, kids, become victim of things like this. I would be somebody. Now, listen to this. Go, quick.
Donc, le pasteur veut parler de 8 types d'amour. Mais aujourd'hui, spécialement, il va parler de 4. Donc, le premier type d'amour, c'est l'amour affectif.
Now, you can't tell me you love me. You can't tell me you love me. I have children before you met me. And then you come to my house. And the moment you come to my house, hey, baby, baby, where are you? My children are closer to you. My children are even coming to you. I was telling daddy, no, daddy, you are not even looking at their face. You don't care about them. And you are coming to me. And what you want is, you just want to swallow me. Amen.
Amen.
Donc, souvent, les femmes sont
souvent victimes de l'amour affectif. Alors, donc, il parle d'un jeune homme tout bon qui va se voir, qui chantait le violon.
One day, one of my daughters, he was calling, he said, you see, she's been praying for her husband. She had this man, the man have money, the man have everything. He said, Pastor, but when this guy come in the house, he doesn't even look at my children. He doesn't even set his eyes on them. His concentration is only me. I said, you know what, you're in trouble. A man like this will never help you. Because if you love me, you love everything about me. You love my animals. You love everything about me. That is love. Say love. But those kind of love is the kind of love, ladies and gentlemen. You see, the time he saw you, you were so slim. So he said, oh, this is what I'm looking for. That time you were so big. So he looked at you and said, I love body. I love this kind of woman. Now he really enjoyed everything about you. Now something happened in life. Storms in life are inevitable. Anything can happen. You know, maybe you were a big woman. Something can happen. And you begin to get slim. Then he look at you and say, you know, look at her. Because he will not love you because, you see, economics people will say marginal utility. The kind of taste that you were having is not diminishing. Summarize it a little.
Donc, les personnes, un homme qui va vous voir, vous dit qu'il vous aime, alors que vraiment il ne vous aime pas, c'est-à-dire qu'il va venir vous voir, même vos enfants, il est censé aimer. D'abord, il ne va pas les aimer, son attention va être sur toi. Dans la vie, n'importe quoi peut arriver. Il peut vous rencontrer peut-être que vous êtes en bonne mine, en bonne santé. À partir du moment où vous allez perdre, par exemple, du poids, bon, pour les hommes africains qui aiment la corpulence,
shout and say, put your hands together for Jesus. Oh, somebody put your hands together for Jesus. And then there is another law called the filial law. Say the filial law. And that kind of law is the kind of law from father to daughter. That is the one we derive from our families. Okay, you love your family, you love your friends, you love people around you. You know, so that kind of law is the law between me and Dorothy. If the world forsake her, I will never forsake her. Because I love her. Continue.
Donc, l'amour filial. Il veut parler de l'amour filial. L'amour qui nous lie à nos parents, à nos familles.
And then, there is another love. Say another love. Called the storage love. Say the storage love.
Troisième type d'amour.
That is the kind of love. That is a relationship love. That is a brotherly love. Say brotherly love. That is the kind of love between Jacob, what do you call it? David and Jonathan. Shout this, I believe.
I believe.
And the last one is called the agape love. Say the agape.